if you want to hear my progress on the Partners in Cream project, then stick around. Hi there, it's Hélène, and welcome back, or if it's your first time, welcome to HMM Makeup, or Makeup. I am so pleased to bring you an update on the Partners in Cream project. It has been 3 months since July 11th that I have not updated. So we've got July to August, August to September, and September to October, which I am filming today, October 10th. It'll probably go up October 11th. So it seems to be July 11th and now October 11th. I have a big update for you because even though I haven't been updating you every month, I have still been using all the products that I said I would be using. And so I have a bunch here and I have another one here, and I want to walk through all of these with you. First off, the product in this container, or what was in this container, I have not used yet. And the product in this container I have not used yet, but that is about to change for both of these. So I'll explain that in a second. Even though I haven't used them yet, they are going to be displacing products that I'm running out of, which is really good news. And all of those products are in this quad, which is, this has been the best thing for me in this project because this quad is my go-to for cream products every single time. And that is why I keep transferring products into it, because it's the one thing I need to pick up. I don't need to be hunting for other things. I can just pick up this one quad and have pretty much everything that I need. The exception to that is this little guy, which is a Jo Fresh blush in, it's Peach Dream. I think it is, yeah, Peach Dream blush. And it makes me think of the NARS Orgasm blush. And this is all that I have left. And so I'm going to show you a comparison of this compared to what it was last update in the progress pictures. And I will put a timestamp right on the screen here. So if you want to go to the progress pictures, you can go straight there. But I will show you a comparison. As soon as I have room in the quad, this quad, I will be transferring what is left of this blush into that quad, so it's in one spot and I don't have to hunt for this applicator at all. And there's quite a bit, you can see what you see here, but there's quite a bit underneath to dig out when I transfer it to the quad. And let me just show you how big this used to be, because I have this highlighter that I've barely used that is exactly the same packaging from the same company. And that way you can see just how much progress I've made on the blush. And you would say, well, why haven't you made progress on the highlighter? It's because I've been using a different highlighter. But you see how much of the blush I've used? I'm pretty happy about that. And I don't have, I have not done weights on these products over the last 3 months. If you want to know what's been going on, if you have not seen my life update in the latest channel chat, I'll put that video right there for you without going into a bunch of detail. This other one has changed. As I said, I have transferred, so there's nothing in this end and there's nothing in this end. So this specific one has been the one that I have transferred the most, or most recently. I had done this one some time ago, and this was foundation. This other one is contour, and this is the Smashbox contour and foundation stick. I really do like this product, and if they still make it, I doubt it, but if they still make it, I would buy it again. I really, really liked it quite a bit. Foundation products, actually Smashbox products in general, are really good. My eyeshadow today, for the most part, is Smashbox. I really like Smashbox products, and I really wish, wish that they had done better than they had. The Smashbox Matte Exposure is my pen. That palette has been for the last 3 years. I think it does really great eye looks. It's very dependable, lots of fantastic functioning mattes, and yeah, it's just too bad that they're not doing as well as I would hope they would. So if you're curious, Smashbox Matte Exposure is the palette that I've used for my eye look today, along with the Make Believe in Yourself. And if you're curious, I have Trance on the inner to two-thirds of the lid. That's what I've used. So if you have not been playing with this palette recently, dig it back out because it's pretty darn good, at least in my opinion. Okay, I have stalled enough. I'm sure you want to see what's in here. So I have four products still, but two of them are just about done. So this is my Cover FX Moonlight Highlighter. I am wearing the blush, the contour, and the highlighter on my face today. Blush here, I've got the highlighter, and I've got contour around my hairline and in the hollow of my cheeks. And as you can see, it's either 1 or 2 months I have left here and 1 or 2 months I have left here. So these guys, before the end of the year, they'll be gone. Now down here, that is where I have transferred. I'm pretty sure that's the one. It's in both. So these two are from the that contour stick. There was quite a bit in it on this side. So that is in these couple of spots in the quad. I'm pretty sure that it's the same product, but I'm pretty sure that's at least the one. But there was more product than that. So I think I split it between the two pans. But anyway, I will have more contour than I can use by the end of the year. But I am going to predict that these two are going to be done by the end of the year, and I'll be using these two as replacement products for those two pans at the top. These two down here, I have no chance of completely finishing. It's just that is just way too much product. Now that I understand how little contour it takes to do the look that I want, this is a year's worth of product at least. So cream products, it's amazing how little it takes to do a look. And so if anything, it makes me even more grateful for the Partners in Cream project. So I'll do a weight on this one, but I don't have weights for the last 3 months. I will just do a weight update today. But again, there is a difference because these are new. And so I don't know that the weight is going to be all that meaningful. It's just kind of almost like a reset. But visually, you will definitely see a significant difference in these two pans as far as progress. I feel very, very lucky in having almost finished the top two products here and getting really close to being able to depot this blush into this quad. So as far as I'm concerned, this is a fantastic project. I've made a ton of progress on products that I did not want to have go bad in my collection. I've really been enjoying them, and I'm so thankful to DaLin and to Steph for having created this project, and I'm really hoping that they are going to continue it on next year. I'm going to stop talking. Let's take a look at the progress pictures. And I'll wrap it up at the end. So that's it. I hope that you are as excited about the progress as I am. Let me know if you have thoughts or suggestions. I'm always open to that. And apart from that, I'm going to say thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it every single time. If you are participating in this project, let me know how it's doing in the comments. I would love to hear from you. And With that, I'll say thank you for watching. I appreciate it, and we'll see you next time. But for now, take care.